Yes, stupid, it's time to sell, are the words that Alex Becker recently did in his latest video in regards to crypto gaming coins and when to go ahead and take profits. So all your crypto, this means it's over. I actually went ahead and broke down the information. Maybe I'll be giving some of my own spicy takes in regards to it all. But Alex Becker's the guy, when he talks about crypto, we go ahead and we listen because he's made some pretty crazy gains, to say the least. We've gotten some 10Xs so far, but we haven't gotten to the illustrious 100X. And that's a problem psychologically for a lot of people. So I hope you enjoy this kind of content. As always, like and subscribe for the daily uploads in crypto gaming specifically. We are all in, one of the few channels doing it. So you want to be in the know? Well, you got to be in here. So let's get right into this video. The first thing he touches base on is human psychology. Human psychology is a big part of what is to be life-changing gains. Because he says himself that when there is a coin, there are three things that you need to be looking at in regards to when you should be taking profit. The first thing is, what is the coin, right? What is the crypto gaming coin? Where in the entire cycle is it? Is it part of the main narratives? When you click on cryptocurrencies, do you see gaming as one of the top niches? Well, you do, by the way. It's right here. I don't know if anybody's noticed, but it's right there. And so, given it's one of the top niches, are we going to be taking profit right now, or are we going to be waiting into further in the cycle when it makes more sense? But here's the problem. Most people will say, okay, well, I'll go ahead and wait, and I'll be a happy camper. But at the end of the day, there were these two big old tops. A lot of people said that Bitcoin was going 100K, did not go to 100K, and said it went down. Looked like this correction, looked like, well, okay, we're just going to bounce back again, guys. Don't worry about it. And no, just the dip kept on dipping and dipping and dipping and dipping. And then you said, okay, you know what? Maybe it is the bear market. Maybe I should sell everything. And then everything went back up. And that's how most humans work. That's why most humans don't end up making it. And he says that, it's simply put, if you are a person, you will not time the top. There is a 99.99999% chance that you're just not going to get the top. And being someone that agrees with this take, he says that once a crypto coin 2Xs, 3Xs, and by the way, when he talks about Bitcoin, he talks about smaller altcoins because he doesn't think that Bitcoin can have the amount of Xs needed to go ahead and facilitate life-changing gains, which is the entire reason why people are in crypto gaming. If you look at our top 10 crypto gaming tokens portfolio, it's already up 203%. Very conservative portfolio. You do this on Bitcoin in the same period of time, it's only up somewhere around 24-25%. So a big differentiator in terms of gains there and the potential that you can get. What he says, and this is something I always advocate on the channel, is once you get 2-5x gains, you should be taking your initial investment out. Because the fact is that at some point in the market cycles, this dip will continue to dip forever. And you want to go ahead and make sure that you do not have to worry about this. It's why I talk about nodes. It's why I talk about the many different passive income resources, so that you don't have to have your head constantly thinking about, when am I going to take profit on this? Because sure, we're still early on in this bull cycle. We've had a good run. We've had a bit of a dip, then we ended up going right back up. We're probably going to have a couple more of these, and that's why you see in the thumbnail, it kind of looks like this. You should be taking profit periodically every single time we have one of these little local tops, and you think that there is going to be any sort of correction. You should be taking some sort of profit. And before you tell me that I am buying coins right now, none of this applies to me, well, ladies and gentlemen, yes, it does apply to you, because you are someone that is getting into the crypto markets right now on what probably is this right here. You should probably go ahead and understand that there might be a dip, and then there's going to be that little correction up top. Take some profit on this one. If you're late, then unlucky for you. I hope you dollar cost averaged instead of being a little bit late. You've got a good 4 to 6 of these little things before you get completely wrecked, so don't worry too much about it. It's Alex Becker's take here. However, it is good to take profit. There is nothing wrong with taking profit. Most people will not time the top. There will be some very lucky people that do get it. 85% of people, though, are going to get wrecked. Because if one of your crypto coins are going up 50x, you are taking profit on someone and dumping your bags on top of a bunch of people that will likely not take profits when they need to take profits. And when the dip comes, it comes very violent. When crypto coins go up, historically speaking, the best cryptos have a lot of negative price action. A great example of this would be something like Bonk, where earlier this month, it did crazy, crazy price movements, almost 10x in a very short period of time. It's up 328%. Boom, had a big correction. And if you got up here, then you're probably really frustrated, right? You're really frustrated about Bonk. But if you got down here, you're happy. This is why, you know, as you're buying up here, you need to, the second it seems like there's some kind of correction and you're up 2 to 5x, you should be taking some sort of profit. And just to give you an example of something, you know, something that's really hot right now is on, you know, the Solana ecosystem. It keeps mooning. It doesn't stop mooning. It seems like it might just keep going up forever. There are coins like Sure Atlas that have had some pretty excellent price action over the past month, up 100%. That is a pretty good piece of price action, up 104% on the entire year. It went pretty much all the way down to the ones. It is almost what, like 4 to 6x in a pretty short period of time because of Solana's success and the narrative. You've got to ask yourself, how much longer is Solana going to keep running up? Personally, I still think that we have a lot of room on Solana, which is why if you're watching this video right now, I wouldn't be too worried about taking profit. I still think, psychologically speaking, the mental health battle of holding a coin once it's already up 100 to 300% is something that most human beings are not used to. You're used to going ahead and hopping over to the stock market, buying your S&P 500 index because everybody's told you that this is the way that you make millions by the time you're 60 years old. And then, you know, you get your price gains, maybe like 10 to 30% max in a single year. You're happy with that. And, you know, you're holding that comfortably. But when your little portfolio goes up 100% in 1 month, your brain is out of the loop. Simply put, it is out of the loop. It does not know what to do because it's been used to for so long getting these consistent small percentage gains over time that when you get 3 to 10 years worth of gains in a single month, it's something that it's like, think of it like a drug addiction, like a gambling addiction that you just can't get enough of and you need to keep getting it and you just stop everything, your brain motors, they stop spinning and you hold your tokens because you want to get another 2x on top of that. And then boom, you lose all of your money. That's the problem. That's the problem with crypto. That's why we always, most people will lose money. And so you got to ask yourself here, how much more can a coin go? If you invest into a coin right now, and of course, do your own research on this, on whatever coin it is. I'm not even going to show you the coin because I don't want to like influence people and then they buy this coin. They're like, oh my God, this coin. Whatever coin it is, right? If you get into a coin, how much more can it go? For example, if you get a coin right now, it's worth $5 million. For it to get to a $500 million market cap, it takes a pretty good amount of capital, let's be honest. But that's a 10 to 100x worth of capital, right? $50 million, that's what? Let's say a 10x, right? That took you 45 million worth of capital. To do another 10x here, you need a $450 million worth of crypto, which for crypto coins like Avalanche, that's fine. But for crypto coins like, I don't know, this random game that just came out on Epic on its open beta that has some random NFT collection that looks pretty mediocre, probably has a bunch of Lyra assets on it. Do you really think that this thing is going to get 450 more million more dollars? And even when it gets to 500 million, just to get another 2x after that, it's going to take $500 million to get to $1 billion. Does that make any sense? Is it worth the risk to reward? Probably not, which is why most people don't get into crypto gaming coins that are worth $1 billion or 500 million, unless you're Immutable X. If you're Immutable X, then you know what, you won the game. But 99% of these crypto coins will not get to that point. Simply put, if you're at 5 million though, literally anything can happen. Someone can cough and then you could go ahead and be at 50 million. People just go ahead and do a little tweet. They become a little radical on your coin. Boom, you went up to the moon. So that makes a lot more sense in terms of risk to reward. But your risk to reward, once you get all the way up there, just doesn't make any sense. Once you were up 5 to 10x on a coin, your risk to reward significantly increases because not only do you have way more capital in that coin, so your actual tolerance is way different. Let's say your net worth is $10,000 and you've decided to put $1,000 into a crypto gaming coin because your buddy over at Walmart goes ahead and tells you, you should go ahead and grab this coin. You buy the coin, it goes up 10x. You've got $10,000 on this coin. It has a $400 million market cap. It's that random game from Epic Games. You are like, oh my God, I'm on top of the world. If I just get one more 2x, then my net worth will double to $30,000. Because remember, 10K, 10K, 20K. Now I want to go to 30K. We're going to greet it out. We don't care. Our $800 million market cap. Let's go. Everybody dumps on you. Meta changes. Nobody cares about your coin anymore. And you are once again wrecked. Versus, you put $1,000 in. Coin 2X's has a bit of a correction. You go, you know what? I'm going to take half my initial investment out. I'm happy with this 2K. That's fine. Whatever. I take 1K. I only have 1K in. And then the coin proceeds to continue. It does that little 10X that we just talked about. It goes away. Boom. You have $5,000 in there. Your net worth has gone up 50% in a very short period of time. You take your profits. You run out of there. And you survive to live another day during the crypto bull market. Because guess what? At the end of the day, these coins, they will correct. Bad things will happen. And you need to assess if it is worth risking. Because that's the thing. If you're going to a market as risky as the crypto gaming market, or just the crypto markets in general, if you're buying microcaps, then your risk to reward should be significantly lopsided to the upside. If you're buying a coin at a $1 million market cap that has an extreme risk, you probably want at least a 10 to 50X on this coin. If you're buying a coin that is at a $1 billion market cap, you should probably not expect more than a 2 to 10X on this coin. It's simply put, market caps are extremely important to go ahead and understand, to know when you should be taking your profits. However, 2024, late to 2025, you need to be aggressively selling and taking some of that money out. So let me know if this video helps you. I tried to TLDR the entire Alex Becker videos. Those are like 40 minutes long. I know you guys love it when I go ahead and break it down. And last, I did some of my own little pointers. I hope this helps you. Seriously, take this into consideration. I know there's a lot of you out there that would much rather just hold it until 2025 and then, you know, screw the influencers. They're all stupid. Even though they've been here for an entire cycle before me or two cycles before me, and they've been through the dips and they bought in DCA this entire time, and they, you know, they made a bunch of money in the space. They're bad. Guys, we know a thing or two. We know a thing or two. So let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Thank you for watching the video. Stay classy, and that's all.